Hello, my name is Tara and I work with Vestavia Hills Library in the Forest. In today's Creative Corner video, I will be showing you how to make a lyric plate. A lyric plate is a plate or a cup that has been memorialized with either a song lyric, quote, or poem. These are perfect to decorate your home or give as a gift. To get started for this project, you will need the following supplies. Plate or a cup of your choosing. A paint pen. The brand I am using is a CraftSmart paint pen. Another brand you can use is Sharpie's oil-based paint pens. Both of these can be purchased at your local arts and crafts store. You will need access to an oven, a quote, song lyric, or a poem. You will also need a plate hanger. These you can get from your local arts and crafts store. Optional supplies include the following. Paint brushes, a paper plate or a palette, masking tape. Multi-surface acrylic paint. The type of paint that I am using will permanently set after being baked at 350 degrees Fahrenheit for 30 minutes and then left to cool in the oven. However, any acrylic paint that will stick to ceramic or glass will work. Be sure to read the instructions on the back of the paint that you use if you do decide to use acrylic paint. Before I get started, I wanted to take a moment to talk about paint pens as this may be your first time using them. Paint pens are not like normal markers or Sharpies. You may think that these pens are completely dry and useless, but they're not. These pens have paint loaded inside the paint barrel instead of ink, and the paint won't be on the pen tip like with ink when you use it the first time. When you open the pen for the first time, it will look like this. The felt tip can come out and actually has no paint on it at all. To load the pen with paint, first make sure that the cap is securely in place and shake the pen for 1 minute. After you have done this, open the pen again and press the felt tip several times slowly into the pen barrel, like so. Be careful while doing this step so as to not get paint on you. I like to use the back of the pen cap to do this on, or a piece of paper will work fine. Be patient and wait a moment, and you will start to see paint flow onto the pen tip. You will do this for every new pen that you use, and when reusing older pens. As you are using the pens, if the pen tip starts to run out of paint, press the tip again and it should reload the paint. When using paint pens on ceramics, it's best to bake them in the oven afterwards. This allows the paint to become permanent to the ceramic glaze and won't wear off as easily. Set your oven to 350 degrees Fahrenheit and place the ceramic pieces in the oven and set the timer for 30 minutes. After the 30 minutes, turn off the oven and leave the ceramic pieces to cool in the oven until they're safe to touch. You will want to hand wash these to make sure that they last longer if you plan to use them for eating. Be sure to take the sticker off the bottom of the plate or cup before you put it in the oven. Next, you may be wondering why we are not using regular Sharpies for this project. They're permanent, right? Well, not on everything. Before I started this project, I actually had this same question and decided to do a little test. As you can see here, I tested several different pens, markers, and paints to see which would be best and most permanent before and after baking in the oven. I did this with the CraftSmart paint pens, normal Sharpies, Sharpie paint pens, dry eraser, Crayola markers, highlighters, and two different types of paint, one that is meant to be painted on glass while one that is not. As you can see with this plate depicted here, there are two sides, one side that I left baked and the other side that I left unbaked. I did three tests to each side. On each of them, I scratched toward the left, used the soft side of a scrub brush toward the middle, and the hard side of a scrub brush toward the right. The Crayola marker, dry eraser marker, and highlighter were erased right away. The normal Sharpie is hard to tell, but on both the baked and unbaked side, it appears cloudy on the edges, as you can see here on this close-up. The CraftSmart paint pens and the Sharpie paint pens were hardly affected. The only damage I can see is the scratches I did toward the left of the CraftSmart pens on the unbaked side. The scratches were not visible on the baked side. The only negative thing to note about baking the paint pens is the color will change. The gold turned to a copper color, while the red turned to a pink, and the silver became dull. The acrylic paints did really well. The only damage I noticed was a scratch on both types of paint on the unbaked side. Both paints did really well when baked, even though that the pink paint isn't meant for glass and ceramics. Overall, any type of paint pen will work, just note that there will be discoloration. After my test, it seems that if you want to be able to use and wash the plate, it is best to bake them. Because regular Sharpies get cloudy, I would only recommend using them if you plan to not touch or wash the plate, and keep it for purely decorative reasons. Now that that is out of the way, let's get started on making our lyric plates. The first step you'll need to do is to actually pick a quote, lyric, or poem that you want to use on your own plates. For the first plate, I decided to use the lyrics from the song Devotion by Michael Oakley, which you can see here. This song is about love and devotion and would make a great wedding reception song. I decided to write the words of my favorite part of the song and write the word devotion in gold. I decided later to add the wedding rings and to use the gold multi-surface paint here. For this plate, I did the quote, "Don't tell me the sky's the limit when there are footprints on the moon." I wrote these words in the center of the plate, as you can see here. I also decorated it with some constellations in the moon. I had a printout of the constellations to help me when drawing the stars. Before I started writing the words on the plate, I wanted to make sure that the spacing would be right before permanently writing them on the plate. To help me with this, I wrote the words on a strip of paper that was the same length as the center of the plate to make sure it would fit. For the moon, I did 3 layers of the paint pens to make sure it would stand out more. For this one, I decided to use a mug instead. Something different. I think I picked it because it was blue and I wanted to play off of that for the flower theme that I wanted to do next. I used the quote from Helen Keller, "The best and most beautiful things in the world cannot be seen or even touched, but they must be felt with the heart." I decided to draw dandelion seeds floating in the wind since I had a limited amount of colors to work with, and I figured that would be a good choice. For this plate, I decided not to add any words, and to just play with the materials that I had available. I think this one came out really well, and I added it to my display shelf in my home. After I was done writing and painting on these, I then put them in the oven. Again, you want to set your oven to 350 and put it in the oven for 30 minutes and let it cool while in the oven until it's safe to touch. And there you have it. You are now left with beautiful decorative lyric plates that you can decorate your home with or give as a gift. Thank you everyone for watching and have a great day.